Hello students, welcome once again to this channel. In this video series we have been seeing this 2 and 3 mark question and answers of chapter 1 of class 11 physics in Tamil Nadu State Board syllabus. Come on, let us continue with the question and answers. Before that, you better subscribe this channel and share it with your friends and click the bell icon so that you get the notifications immediately as and when we upload them. Okay, come on. The ninth question: define mean absolute error. The arithmetic mean of absolute errors is called mean absolute error. We have already studied about absolute errors. For example, if there are 5 absolute errors, you add them all and divide it by 5, you get the arithmetic mean. Here delta A m represents, here m indicates mean of the absolute errors. So this is the expression for mean absolute error: modulus of delta A1 plus modulus of delta A2 up to delta An divided by n terms. Okay. Now let us move on to the next question. Define relative error. The ratio of the mean absolute error to the mean value is called relative error. So it is nothing but the ratio in between mean absolute error and mean value. So delta AM represents mean absolute error and AM represents mean value. This expression gives the relative error. Next question is, define percentage error. The relative error expressed in percentage is called percentage error. If we express the relative error in percentage, then it becomes the percentage error. This is the expression for percentage error. Percentage error is equal to delta AM by AM into 100%. Next question, find the expressions for errors in sum and difference of two quantities. When we add two quantities, then we get errors. We need to find out the expression for it. Similarly, if we find the difference in between two quantities, there also we may get errors. We need to find the expression for it also. Now, the first one is error in the sum of two quantities. Let delta A and delta B be the absolute errors in the two quantities A and B respectively. Then, here A and B are added, so we get Z. So delta Z is the error in the sum of A plus B, that is Z. So how do we write the expression? Delta Z is equal to delta A plus delta B. Next one, error in the difference of two quantities. Here also, let delta A and delta B be the absolute errors in the two quantities A and B respectively. So here you can see Z is here, Z represents the difference in between the two quantities A and B. So Z is equal to A minus B. Therefore delta Z is nothing but the error in the difference, that is Z. So here also the expression is delta Z is equal to delta A plus delta B. You shouldn't get confused. Here it is written A minus B. So we may get delta A minus delta B like that, not like that. For sum and difference of two quantities, the expressions are same. Next question, find the expressions for errors in the product and quotient of two quantities. First one, error in the product of two quantities. Let delta A and delta B be the absolute errors in the two quantities A and B respectively. Then here you see, here this Z is nothing but the product of two terms A and B, two quantities. So here delta Z is the error in the product Z. Now let us see, how can we write the expression? The expression is delta Z is by Z is equal to delta A by A plus delta B by B. Next one, error in the quotient of two quantities. Let delta A and delta B be the absolute errors in the two quantities A and B respectively. Here, Z is nothing but A divided by B. So delta Z is the error in the quotient Z. Then how do you write the expression? Delta Z by Z is equal to delta A by A plus delta B by B. Here also the same thing for product and quotient. The expressions are one and the same. It doesn't look different. They look alike. Next question. How will you measure the diameter of the moon using parallax method? Here we need to draw a small supportive diagram for it. Here is the earth and here is the moon. And this is the diameter of the moon. And from the two edges of the moon, let us draw two lines. And these two lines subtend an angle at this point, let it be theta. And this distance is indicated by means of small d. This is the distance in between the earth and the moon. Now let us see the answer. Theta is the angular diameter. D is the diameter, whereas theta is the angular diameter of the moon. And small d is the distance in between the earth and the moon. And capital D is moon's diameter. So from the figure, we can write the angle theta is equal to capital D by D, which is nothing but the diameter of the moon divided by the distance in between the moon and the earth. So from this expression, we can get capital D is equal to theta. If this D goes this side, it becomes multiplied. So therefore, capital D is equal to small d into theta. By using this expression, we can find the diameter of the moon. So with this equation, we can find the diameter. So with this question, this video has come to an end. Let us meet with some more questions in the next video.
Like, share and comment and subscribe our channel and click the bell button for more videos. Thank you.